Hi, my name is Patrick Murphy Racy, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit about the Nikon 300F 4E PFED, which is a big, long model name for the brand new lens from Nikon, which exhibits new technology for Nikon, but not so new for Canon, who have been making DO lenses for many years. I used to own the 400F4 DO lens, and I really liked it. It was a very, very good lens, but I happen to love to shoot backlit, especially with field sports like football, baseball. And those lenses were pretty weak when you shot backlit. There'd be a lot of flare and issues like that that would come in, and it would really affect the contrast, the overall contrast of what was going on. So this lens seemed to be much improved. Of course, they've had a lot of time to think about what they wanted to do. The key element in here is this PF. We all know what ED is, we all know what AFS is, but the PF, and the F stands for Fresnel, and a lot of people, especially younger people, may not know what a Fresnel is. And so here is a Fresnel. This is an element that comes out of a light. It's flat on one side, and then the other side has all these little grooves in concentric circles that go around. And the idea behind the Fresnel is that what they do is they simply use the same size piece of glass, or the same size element of glass inside here, but on one side of the lens you have these grooves and these cuts. Then on the interior of the lens, that the imperfections that are caused by this weirdness are corrected back to normal before the light goes all the way through back to your sensor. So it's a really neat technology, and it's no wonder that the lens costs $2,000, which I think is actually a pretty good deal. I've been shooting mine for basketball, and last night I shot my son's basketball game at his grammar school. And those of you that are photojournalists, you know that when you go to a grammar school, it's worse than high school usually, and it was. And I was shooting a bunch of images at 6400 ISO with the new lens, the 300F4. I was shooting at 500th at f4, and you can kind of see the results. The lens, the thing that was most impressive to me about it was it seemed to act like a 300-28 or a 200-2, even in super low light, even though it's an f4. This Fresnel business is capturing a lot more light, and it's able to put more light back on the sensor than a normal conventional optic. And so I was able to see this for real, and also obviously the nano coating is going to help immensely with flare that was always the DO problems on the Canon side. So I just think this is a fantastic lens. It's really worth $2,000 for me. And I think for many people, if you're in a modern Nikon DSLR, if you're in the D750 or the D4, D4S, these cameras that have this extreme high ISO capability, you may not need a 2.8 anymore, because this thing, it rocked. And then I'm also going to have a gallery of some college basketball that I'm going to actually shoot tonight, so you can kind of see how it does. But I tell you, I don't think I'd be giving up a whole lot in performance, if anything really, versus a 300-28. In terms of its acquisition speed, its ability to stay on target, the speed at which it acquires, and then the way it tracks. It tracks really well. So I'm very, very impressed. I'm hoping this is the first of many new PF optics from Nikon, because it's a really cool lens. I'm gonna probably be using this as my long lens when I'm shooting Sony mirrorless as well, because it's small, it's light, it's perfect for that kit as well. So I could see using this on my A7 II all day long for weddings or whatever. So anyway, I hope this has been helpful to you. I hope it helps you in your sort of decision about what you're gonna do for gear. $2,000 is a whole lot less than a new AFS VR2 version 300-28. So it might be something to think about. I think it's interesting that they even neglected to ship it with a collar. Now, some people are gonna think that's bad, that they were cheap. I get it though. You could walk around with this thing for weeks and weeks and weeks over your shoulder connected to a camera body, and because it's so lightweight and not real long, it's not going to bash into things, it's not going to be heavy and stress that mount. So I don't really see the need for a tripod mount or collar of any kind. It's nice that they have the facility to use it though, which is great. Thanks very much for watching.